Mega Polytech Te Pūkenga was born from the merging of the country's 16 institutes of technology and polytechnics, along with its four industry training organisations, into one mammoth entity. The government sees it as critical in resolving the country's ongoing skills shortages. But now, some observers reckon it's Te Pūkenga that's in a critical condition, with piling up problems that include a blown-out deficit and declining enrolments. We invited Education Minister Chris Hipkins onto the show this morning to discuss it, but due to a previous commitment, he provided us with a statement instead. We'll get to that shortly, but first, we're joined by National Party Tertiary Education spokesperson Penny Simmonds in Invercargill after a hassle at the airport yesterday. Penny, we're talking travel woes later on in the program, and you had one of your own. So we really appreciate you being with us this morning from Invercargill. Yeah, first of all, can you just give us a little bit of background information for us? Because you have a long-standing history with tertiary education, right?
Yes, Maureen and Matty. Yes, I was at the Southern Institute of Technology for 30 years, 23 of those as the chief executive. So I've been in the sector a long time.
Yeah, so you know the sector and you know some of the struggles that it's facing at the moment. What are your major concerns when we look at Te Pūkenga?
Well, my major concerns is that it's a fundamentally flawed model. You can't take 16 polytechnics and just merge them all together and think that that will fix the problem. So some of the polytechnics were well performing, some were not performing as well, and just simply merging them doesn't fix all the problems.
In what way? Because I would have thought that actually creating a centralised system would have potentially been a good thing for the polytechs to kind of learn from each other, to talk to each other, to integrate with each other.
Yeah, we did all those things because we networked together. So we did share. We had joint forum. We shared curricula. So there was a lot of that integration going on as well. But when you merge them all and you take the decision making away from the front line, away from those that are delivering the education and the services, and you pull that into a head office made up of primarily people who have never run a polytech, who know nothing about what it's like to be on the front line teaching, then you get perverse decisions being made that aren't necessarily good for either students or staff or the industries that we should be serving. So the best thing is when a polytechnic is embedded in its community, working with its industries and its community organisations, and having this big bloated head office takes away that integration with your community.
So what have we seen as a result, Penny? What are some of the things that concern you about what's happened as a result of Te Pūkenga?
Well, the financial result is dreadful. Prior to being merged, the net deficit for the sector was 48 million. Now, having spent 200 million, the net deficit is forecast at 110 million. So more than double, having spent 200 million to achieve that dreadful result. So it's been a terrible, wasteful spend to get a much worse outcome. But it's more than the financial, it's also the impact on students and staff. So unifying curriculum, now there's nothing wrong in getting unified curriculum, but for example, with the Bachelor of Nursing, the Tertiary Education Union had to mount a petition to stop this being rushed through and being rolled out next year because the staff just hadn't been consulted with sufficiently. They hadn't been given time to develop their delivery material and their assessments. So it's putting tremendous pressure on staff who are already under pressure given what they've gone through with COVID.
Although if we look at the sector as a whole, do you agree that change was needed? I'm going to read from the statement that Minister Hipkins has provided us from. And he said, under the old model, long-term deficits were projected, rising up to $156 million in 2022. When Labor came into government, we had to pump around $100 million into a number of polytechnics just to keep the lights on. The model was unsustainable. So do you agree that change was needed?
It wasn't the model that was unsustainable. Those big deficits were occurring in about six or seven polytechnics. So there needed to be change in those polytechnics. Now, it was for a range of reasons. Some were just too small to operate on their own. Some were being not well managed and not well governed. The forecasted deficits were never peer-reviewed. They were never looked at as whether the assumptions were right or not. They were set up as a reason for doing this merger. So I think you can take those forecasted big deficits with a grain of salt. But yes, something did need to be done, but it needed to be focused and it needed to be targeted on the areas where there was a problem, not throwing the whole sector, the whole 16 polytechnics and all the ITOs up into disarray, because that didn't fix anything. It needed to be very targeted and looked at the business model of those that were not performing well.
And so what would you suggest? What would National do differently? Because as you mentioned, change was needed in the sector. So what kind of change would you like to see?
Look, there's a combination of things. First of all, it needs to, the decision making needs to go back to the individual polytechnics and to their communities. Then there did need to be funding looked at, because over successive years, tens of millions of dollars had been taken out of the polytech sector with base grants and research top-ups and things gone. So there was a lot of money that had gone out of the sector. And then there needs to be a focus on those polytechnics that are not well performing, and they need to be given the support by those that are well performing to bring them up to speed. There were some things that could be centralized. Unifying programs is a good thing, but you must do it with staff. You must have staff engagement and involvement so that they are ready and prepared. You can't throw changes at staff with just a few months' notice.
I'm reading from the statement again from Minister Hipkins, who said, "I've been clear that the projected deficit was too high and that more work needed to be done there." Do you think that this is something that can be saved? Can we make something of this? Clearly, we've come to this decision to merge the polytechs together. So we kind of just need to get on with it, right, Penny?
Well, no, because you can't keep throwing good money after bad, and the due diligence wasn't done. So when the consultation occurred, all the submissions said this isn't the right model. Those that were experienced in the sector said this isn't the right model. It's not going to achieve the efficiencies that you want to achieve. So, no, I don't think it is the right thing to just keep throwing money into it. I think that you need to get back to the basics of where there is fundamental wrong business models, and they need to be targeted and fixed. But you don't do that just by pulling a sector all together. So no, I don't think we should just get on with it at all, because to pull back that kind of deficit, you are talking hundreds of redundancies. That's the only way you can pull back a deficit like that. And at the moment, most of the growth has been in non-teaching staff in head office. So almost 200 people are sitting in head office now, an extra layer of bureaucracy. That's where a lot of the cost is sitting.
Penny, thank you so much for your time this morning, and your insight as well, as someone who's spent a long time in the tertiary education sector. That is Penny Simmonds, the National Party Tertiary Education Spokesperson, joining us from Invercargill this morning.